How are people using social media in relation to their health and well-being during COVID-19 and beyond? I'm Dr. Victoria Gajir from the School of Sport, Exercise and Rehabilitation Sciences at the University of Birmingham, and we are launching a new study investigating the role of social media in physical activity, diet nutrition, pain, and our overall quality of life. This is because we think that some of the social distancing measures may be impacting on the different ways in which our body moves and feels. We also know from our prior research is that social media can play a very positive role in our health and well-being. For example, it can act as a source of motivation for physical activity, providing different exercise, workouts, or even different competitions that we can do with friends and family. We also know that it can be a valuable source of information on diet and nutrition, different recipes, different smoothies. We also know that it can provide information on different exercises or treatments for pain and overall quality of life, and it can promote well-being. At the same time, we also know that social media does pose some risks. It is a mass user-generated space. There is lots of non-evidence-based information that has the potential to lead to harm with certain groups. So we are interested in how different groups of people are using social media for health and well-being during the COVID-19 pandemic. This may be groups that are shielded and particularly vulnerable. It might be groups that were previously active before the social distancing measures came into place, and they found that their activity levels have decreased. Alternatively, it might be individuals who feel that their health behaviours have changed slightly. Maybe their diet has changed during the COVID-19 and it might be changed for the better. Overall, this information will help us to understand how we can use social media in optimal ways to reach different groups online to promote health and to promote different health behaviours and communicate different messages. The findings will be relevant for policymakers, different researchers, different health organisations, schools and teachers. So how overall then, are you using social media and is it impacting on your health and well-being? If so, the first part of the study is a launch of a survey, a national survey, and we want as much as a representative sample as possible. So please share your thoughts with us. Anyone aged 13 or over can take part. And please share with your colleagues, your friends, your family members. And we look really forward to hearing from you about how social media is impacting on your health and well-being.